Welcome. In this video, I will be providing demonstration of the Event Calendar Maker Excel template. This is the third version of this template, and thanks to everybody who gave valuable feedback based on the previous versions, and that has helped a lot in building additional functionality in this version. In this video, I will be taking step-by-step instructions to create fully personalized, customized calendars using this template very easily. Now I have the template open, and this is a blank template, and we're going to start entering some data into this template to create our own calendars. But before I enter any data, I just want to inform that this is the home sheet where we are going to enter some basic information about our calendar. And then in the events sheet is where we will actually be entering all the events that we want to display on our calendars. And then we have seven sheets. These are the different calendar designs that you will have access to. And these are automatically created, and they are instantly updated as we enter the data in the event sheet. And so you don't need to do anything on these other seven sheets. They're all fully ready-made and done for you. So events is where we will be spending a lot of time entering the data. And before we get to that, we need to have the information updated in the home sheet. So in order to better show how the calendars work while we enter the data, I am going to create another copy of or another window for the same workbook. And I can do that by going to the View ribbon, clicking New Window, and that opens a new window. And I can now resize it. And note that these two windows are of the same workbook. So now I have the two windows. And now we're going to enter the data on the left-hand side here. And we're going to start with the basic settings. 2016 January is when we want the calendar to begin. And on the right side, I am going to select the yearly with events calendar design, because we can now see multiple months instantly. And I am going to now, for example, change the data for the year. So if I want to have a calendar built for 2018, all I have to do is type 2018. And now I can see that the calendar on the right now is for 2018. And you can start the calendar in any month. And you know, you can change it to February, for example, and you'll have 12 months starting from February. So it'll go all the way through January of 2019. And so now you can also change the beginning weekday. For example, on the calendar, you see it begins from Sunday and ends on Saturday. And you can change that by starting from Monday, for example. So these are very customizable according to your unique needs. So I'm going to switch it back to 2016 and January. And then let's say our calendar begins on Sunday. Okay, great. Now, the next thing is non-business days. So if you want to highlight specific weekends or holidays on the calendar as non-business days, then this is where you would do that. And the non-business days are highlighted in red font on the calendars. And by default, it is Saturday and Sunday. But for example, if I want only Sundays to be weekends, then I change it here. And now you can see that the Sundays are shown in red font, but the Saturdays are not. So I'm going to switch it back to Saturday and Sunday. And the holidays are one-off days that you want to call them as non-business days. And so let's say for this example, I'm going to choose January 15, 2016, and then February 16, 2016. And now you will instantly see that the 15th of January and 16th of February are in red font. So that is, and you can also enter the names of the holidays. And please note that this is just for your reference. It doesn't get displayed anywhere on the calendars. And now the next step is to enter event types and assign them colors. This is where I think if you have a lot of events and you want to group them and assign a different color to each of the groups, this is how you can do it. And there can be up to 12 different types of events. So for simplicity, I'm going to just enter two different event types, and I can give them the colors differently. So let's say I give green for all the meetings, and for all the holidays, I'm going to choose purple. And you have 15 choices in terms of colors that you can choose from. And that's pretty much it in the home sheet. Now we're going to go to the events sheet, where we are going to enter events and see how they are reflected on the calendar. The first one, I'm going to just say, this is a company holiday. So event name is the name you give to an event. And in some of the calendar designs, the event names are actually listed. So they will be displayed on some of the calendar designs. So that's the name you want to choose. Event type is one of those two, because we only entered two in the previous sheet. You can choose, for example, holidays and the event start date. So let's say this is the January 15th event, and so January 15th. And the next thing is, I'm going to choose the frequency type first, one time, because it's a one-time event, and instantly I see the event displayed on the calendar with the purple color. The reason why it's in purple is because we actually chose the event type to be holidays, and in the home sheet we told the template that holidays should be in purple color, so that's why it is in purple. And now the reason why we didn't enter event end date is because it's optional for one-time events. One-time event means it happens only on one day, it does not happen again. So now I'm going to enter a recurring event, and let's say we give the name as meeting. And we will choose the event type to be meetings. And we are going to start with January 4th. And I want it to go to January 8th. And the event type would be daily. So this is an event that is going to happen from 4th to 8th every day. And you see that it's still not highlighted on the calendar yet, because for all the event types, frequency types, except one-time events, we need to provide the weekdays. So these are Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, all the weekdays, and we need to put one wherever the weekday is allowed. So if I really want all the weekdays, Monday to Friday, to be allowed, so I'm going to press, I selected all the cells, and then I'm pressed one, and then before I hit enter, I'm going to put control enter, and that will assign one to all these cells. You can definitely type 111 five times, that's fine. But this is a quick short tip that you can use to make your data entry faster. And now I have entered one in all the five cells. You see now that all the 5 days are selected between 4th and 8th. And now if I want only the days every 2 days, once every 2 days should be selected, then I can press 2 in N, and now every 2 days, so for example, this is 4th and then 6th and then 8th, every other day will be selected. If I say 3 every 3 days, what happens is 4th is selected, then 5, 6 are skipped, and then 7th is selected. And then there's nothing else after that, because 8 is the end date of this recurring event. So that's how it works, and the event is assigned green color because the event type we chose was meetings. And if we change this to holidays, they become purple because the event types are mapped to colors. Okay, so now this is a daily event, so I'm going to just take this off, and let's say, for example, we're going to change this to the end of February, for example. And I'm going to create a weekly event. And this weekly event is going to be every Monday. So I choose one for Mondays. And then now every Monday between 4th January and 29th February are highlighted. Great. Now, if I want only every other Monday, I just put two. That just means that every second Monday, right? So this Monday is selected, and then you skip a Monday, and then the next Monday is selected, skip a Monday, next Monday is selected. So you just do two. If I do three, then third Monday, and then the third Monday. So it's the concept works the same way for different event frequency types. So now before I move on to the next one, I'm going to delete these things. And now let's try to create the next event frequency type, which is monthly. So for monthly, I am going to, for example, choose a longer window, and I'm going to choose June 5th. And from 4th Jan to 5th June, I want to create a monthly event, and I'm going to say I'm okay with all the 7 weekdays. So now you see the 4th of every month between January and June will be selected. So 4th January and all of these until 4th June will be highlighted. And if I want only every other month, then I put 2. Then now I get, you know, January, February skipped, March is selected, April is skipped, May is selected. So that's how the N works for monthly events. So if you want, for example, once every 3 months, you could put in 3. If you want once every 12 months, you could put in 12. Then you could create quarterly and annual events as well. So it's very, very powerful in terms of how this can be used to meet your needs. Now, the next frequency type is, I'm going to choose nth weekday of the month. So this one is, since it needs N and also weekday, so I'm going to say, for example, let's do Monday again. So I want nth Monday. So since I haven't entered any N, it picks the first Monday of every month. But if I want the third Monday of every month, I put in 3. Now what happens is third Monday of every month will be automatically selected. So that's how easy it is. And the next option is last weekday of the month. And this time again, I'm saying last weekday, Monday. So last Monday of every month will now be automatically selected. And let's go to the next option, which is last day of the month. So when I choose last day of the month, and you need to make sure that you enter 1 in all the weekdays so that regardless of the weekday, last day of every month will be highlighted. So January 31st, February 29th, March 31st, April 30th, May 31st. All of these days, because the end date is 5th June, so any month between January and June will be highlighted. And the last day of January is 31st, so that is also included. And last day of June is actually June 30th. That will not be displayed because you've put the end date of this recurring event to be June 5th. Okay, so now we are done with that. Let's go to the next frequency type. Every nth business day. So every nth business day, I'm going to type in 4. And this would be every 4th business day will be selected. So 4th, and then after 3 business days, it picks 8. And then after 3 business days, 14th. And then you see that 15th is a holiday. So it will skip 15th. It'll skip 16th and 17th because they are weekends. And then it'll say 18, 19, 20. 21st is the next 4th business day. So every 4th business day can be easily done, and you can type in any N here. And next frequency type we have is nth business day of the month. So four, in this case, we have selected 4. So 4th business day of the month, which would be, for example, here for January, we have 1st, 4th, 5th, and then 6th. So 6th of January is the 4th business day in January. Again, if you have other holidays, then your business day and business day might change. But for our scenario, Saturday and Sunday are holidays, and we have, you know, some holidays entered here as January 15th. So the template uses those as non-business days, and it'll calculate the nth business day of the month. And the same concept applies as we go, last business day of the month. So it will figure out, okay, January 31st is a holiday because it's a weekend. And then January 30th is also a weekend. So January 29th is the last business day of the month. So it'll save you time because you don't need to look up which is the last business day and all this. Template will automatically figure it out. Nth business day of the week, it works the same way. Now this is picking the 4th business day of a week. So for this week, January 4th, the 4th business day is a Thursday, and similarly, all the Thursdays are 4th business days. But let's watch February. In February, 16th is a holiday, so it will take the 4th business day happens to be on a Friday. So again, the template figures it out, and you don't need to worry about figuring out the business day of the week. And I think this is helpful when you have certain types of meetings or events that are supposed to occur every week, but you need, you need to consider holidays into account. And this template, this frequency type will take that into account. Last business day of the week, and for every business day, every week, it'll pick the last business day, usually on a Friday here. But since we are actually having 15th as a holiday, it is smartly picking up 14th, which is a Thursday, as the last business day of this week. So those are the different frequency types. We have expanded on the functionality by adding a lot of additional frequency types, and this will save a lot of time, and which will help you create a lot of recurring events very, very quickly. Using one row of data, you can create instances of many instances of the event very, very quickly. So now we have entered this, and I just want to quickly go through the different calendar designs. I'm going to expand on this window, and now we can see this is the yearly window, and this is a calendar design which does not list the event names, but it'll have the legend and all the colors highlighted. And then yearly with events, this is where our event names will come through. And you also have an additional option of choosing instances here. When you choose instances, it'll list every instance of these events. And so since we had a recurring weekly event, then now it shows up many times. And you can definitely go back to the events if you want to list only events. Monthly design is 12 pages long, one page for each month, and the dates are much larger, so you can print, and the colors are the colors work the same way, and the legend and everything are provided. Monthly with events is more for whenever you have multiple events on the same day, then you can leverage this, because now you can see that on the same day, if you have multiple events, it'll actually list below, and there can be up to five events for a single day. Then the next design, 1 month design, this is very similar, but you only see 1 month at a time, one page only, and you can definitely type in another month and then see the next month, and you can print it. The biggest difference here is that there can be up to 10 events per day. This is one of the most commonly requested feature, to have more than 5 events for one day, and now you can actually see up to 10 events per day. And the next design is weekly with events. And this is where you can actually type in a specific start date, and then you can see the events for the week. And so, for example, let's say I choose 8th January. Now I see for the week beginning on 8th January, I can see all the events listed and the legend. The next design is daily with events. Similarly, you can enter any date, and this will list only the specific day's events. And if you have entered any event descriptions, which we didn't cover, so I want to go back to the events sheet here. We covered how to enter information on this side. There are a few additional pieces of information you can enter: event description or start time of the event, and also a couple of additional columns that you can enter to create more detailed daily calendar. And that is what will be displayed here: the event description and also custom column. For example, I want to show these custom columns here. I'm going to type in, this could be a room number, this could be a building for your event, and you can type in the event description for a specific event, and this will actually be shown up on the daily calendar. So for the start time, you could type in 10 a.m. and this could be 9 a.m. let's say. You could also enter the room number for these two events. So I'm just gonna make something up, and building 1, building 2, for example, and I go to the daily calendar, and now I actually see that information will come through. So you can have up to 20 different events on a single day on this calendar design. And similarly, in the weekly with events, you can have up to 20 different events listed for each day. And that's pretty much it. These are the different designs. And if you want to print any of those, you go and file print, and this will actually print out the calendar design you chose. And you can also export to PDF by clicking export and create PDF, and that'll create a PDF document that you can share within your team. And so if there are any questions about the usage of this template or the features in the template, please leave me a comment in the video comment section, and I will definitely get back to you. Thank you very much for watching the video.